You play in a new game, PSO2. That's a new game? Phantasy Star Online 2 is a new game now? Damn. Alright. I like your attitude. New for you. Okay. That makes more sense. There you go. Phantasy Star Online has been here for quite some time, you know? Didn't play it because they removed the boob bounce from Japan version. Man. So obsessed with boobs. What about the ass? God damn it. These people will never get it. The ass is what matters. You know. Ass bad. You are bad. You know, you will like it. I'm sure you will. At some point. You're gonna get bored and tired of rejecting it, and at some point you're gonna embrace it with two hands. What the fuck kind of spell is this? Bombard? I don't know what that is, and I don't think I care that much. Alright. I just... Damn it, I wish I spanned more on the previous run. That's basically what I needed. I just needed to spam more. Fuck, dude. I'm so pissed now, because I have to build up all the cash. Yet again, at least Reva is gonna be the first character that I fight against. But that was also an achievement that I needed to get, beating Reva as one of the last bosses. It's the way it is. Anyways, you know, another country where Saint Seiya was popular other than Argentina was in Brazil. So my question for you, Yannick, is... Did you watch Saint Seiya? Because I'm pretty sure it was pretty popular. It has even... You don't think you had? Damn. Maybe he's too young. Yeah, that can happen. Like there, at one point Saint Seiya, you know, stop being aired, obviously, and I think the younger generations, including myself, by the way, have not watched it. But you know, I'm planning on changing that. So I hope it's cool. But it should be cool. I mean, it's a battle shonen. The bad thing is that, you know, I sadly, you know that I was watching Mazinger Z, right? I couldn't continue it. Like, I had to leave it halfway through. Because it was so... Like, they didn't know what to do at some point, and they started doing really stupid shit in the show. So, it's a problem, because, like, you know, the reason why I started watching it wasn't there anymore. Or rather, I guess you could say that it was there, but, like, I really had to make a lot of excuses for the show to feel, you know, to feel interesting. I can't believe I'm getting blasted by this character this much. And this is the first, like, the normal version of the character. And I'm still getting fucked. And Reva is not supposed to be that hard to fight against. Just that the damage that she deals against this character seems to be a lot. It doesn't help that she also likes moving a lot, so... You know... That doesn't help at all. I have watched a bit, actually didn't know the English name. That's the Japanese name. The English name, I'm pretty sure the game, the show barely has an English name. Yeah, in Portuguese it's called Os Cavaleiros do Zodíaco, I think. Well, which in Spanish obviously is called Los Caballeros del Zodíaco. But you know, in Japanese it's supposed to be Saint Seiya. But yeah, that's a show that everyone has watched here. Everyone and their moms, well, you know, funnily enough, I remember, you know, I was in a taxi once, and the driver was saying how he didn't allow his son to watch Saint Seiya because, well, obviously, first of all, because of the violence, right? I mean, that's the number one reason why anyone will not like their child to watch Saint Seiya. But then he also said, and this is the funny part, because if he were to say that now, he will be labeled as everything. Maybe, you know, with a good reason. But he also didn't like how some characters, you, like, it wasn't obvious if they were boys or girls, right? Like, for example, the character that Kyle was mentioning, or, you know, the character that uses a chain, that it's supposed to be a boy, but, you know, looks pretty effeminate, right? And that was also another one of the reasons why he didn't let his son watch it. And that's pretty funny, because if someone were to say that now, yeah, you can't say that now. And again, it's probably for the best, because, you know, just because someone looks the way they look doesn't mean that they are something in particular, right? It's just the way they look. Oh. You know, it was like, mom didn't like me watching Naruto. You know, I mean, when it comes to my mother, when I was a kid, she didn't like me watching anything that was anime. Clearly, because it was really violent. And I mean, the animes that were on TV were all battle shonen, so it's not like you had something like, I don't know, what example of an anime that is a slice of life could I give of that time? Actually, I was gonna say The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya, but the thing about that one is that they probably wouldn't like it for different reasons. And it's also understandable. Nichi Show? Yeah, but that's the problem. Those shows, even though they are innocent by our standards, I think they have a lot of stuff that the average parent will consider insanely degenerate. And they will probably be right, it's just that I guess we got so desensitized to that kind of stuff that we don't really notice. But yeah. Anime is not for the parents to watch. No, I mean, well, obviously it's not intended for the parents, but the thing is, if you have a parent that cares about what you consume, which is what it should be, it's pretty hard for them to allow you to watch something like that, and it's understandable. But you know, you also miss out on a lot of stuff that can be pretty cool. You son of a bitch. Get fucked. I caught my mom watching Berserk. I told her about the themes and she didn't give a single fuck. You call your mom watching Berserk? You know, that reminds me of something that is definitely a different story. It's not the same, but it's pretty funny because it's kind of similar in a way. Apparently there was a guy, obviously this could as well be a lie from the guy that said it, but I remember someone on 4chan saying that he caught his mom, you know, feeling herself to, you know, a pretty specific anime, you know, obviously plus 18 anime. I don't even remember which one it was, but it was, you know, that kind of anime. And I'm like, wow, that's something. Because you're like, when you see something like that, you are like, all right, then I have, you know, they are, I'm basically free to, you know, be as much of a degenerate as I want to be, right? Like, at that point, you are like, I can do, like, I have no moral compass because, you know, the person that I'm supposed to be looking up to is basically doing something like this, so I should have no problem doing something like that too. So I can't imagine what that poor guy went through in his head. Do you ever wash that t-shirt? Man, that's the first comment that he leaves. Anyways, how is it going, Colo? Yeah, I washed the t-shirt. You have a problem? You don't like it? I know that you want to see me without a shirt, but you gotta understand, bro, that's against Twitch rules. So I cannot do that. I know you are dying to see me without a shirt, but you just gotta understand. Twitch allows what it allows. Imagine having this and mom. Well, that's the basically the story of that guy. Of that guy on 4chan that say that, and I'm like, wow, good shit. Again, obviously you don't know if it's true or not, since in a place where you are anonymous, you can say whatever the fuck you want, regardless of how much of a lie it is, and people can decide to believe it or not. But if that story were to be real, that's pretty funny. Definitely funny. Obviously traumatic for the poor kid, but you know, it is the way it is. How do I deal with this? I guess teleporting. Yeah, that works. Boom. Definitely don't like your ugly shirt, which is getting more meticulous. What you mean by meticulous? I'm pretty sure that they ban people that don't have a shirt. So I don't know what you mean with meticulous. I think they are doing whatever they are doing, you know? The lasers on this guy are out of control. Damage is also pretty out of control. Everything about this asshole is out of control. And that was pretty close. See, the problem is, if I'm so close to dying against this boss, I don't think I have a chance against the other, sadly. Pretty sad, but... this guy is really a glass cannon, though obviously the fact that I'm not picking up any artifact is not helping. I heard bands have come a trend, yeah. Why do you think about stripping? I'm not thinking about that, you mentioned that. Oh, you know. These ice cubes. Oh, that was pretty lucky. Good shit. Bomb toss. Well, yeah, sure, why not? It's some damage. At least some damage. You teleporting behind me, bitch. Okay. And it doesn't work if it's right in my own cell. Man, this guy is so fucking annoying. The Grim Reaper is such a piece of shit. Anyways, at least he's dead. But I have a hell deficit here. I think I'm definitely going for the bonfire. Yeah, I'm going for the bonfire. Of course, well, I mean, the other option... nah, definitely the bonfire. I mean, well, even if I could buy health, like, even if I could spend money, buying health counts as getting an artifact. So if I'm going for that achievement, I cannot do that. Oh yeah, just not a good idea. Yeah, give me ambush. Give me that one. I like lightnings. I still don't understand why I receive such a humongous amount of damage. Like, the damage is really out of control for some reason. Wow, she went from one route to the other. That's pretty funny. That was close. But yeah, I guess it's because I'm not getting too many shield spells, really. That might be the worst problem here. There we go. What was I about to say? I thought to mention something... it probably wasn't important. Anyways, how are you enjoying PSO2, Yannick? Because... it's a pretty famous game, but I really... don't know how many people are playing it nowadays. I mean, it's a game that... it's been out for a pretty long time. You're still lost. You don't know what to do. Well... I mean... have you tried looking up guides? Maybe that will help. I personally don't like looking up guides, but you know. Swords of Light, that's a Yu-Gi-Oh! Reference. What a stoner comment to say. Do you like RTS games? No, I find them to be incredibly boring. Just like any strategy game, even if it wasn't real time. I mentioned it already multiple times, but I don't like thinking when I'm playing a game. The exception being some puzzle games, but only some of them. I've been deep in guides for a while. Force of Revealing Light prevents enemy from attacking you for 3 turns but can be destroyed. Well, this one apparently cannot be destroyed. Oh yeah. It's the way it is. You know, since I haven't played Yu-Gi-Oh, I wouldn't know. Damn it, no, no, stop shooting. There you go. I just have to do that. Even if I might miss, I just have to spam against bosses, because if I don't, I'm gonna get killed like I got killed the other time. Though obviously I can still spam and still get killed regardless, so. Nothing defeats them. Maybe. Dash forward. Deal damage equal to your missing health on one tile. Nah. Honestly. Yeah, especially if it's a consumed type of spell card, that's just not good for a spell card like that. There is also a trap called Wall of Revealing Light, where you sacrifice life in multiples of 1,000 enemies with an attack lower than that can attack at all, but also can be destroyed since it's a continuous trap. Interesting. Seems like... Yeah, seems like Yu-Gi-Oh is not made for me, that's for sure. You're playing Yu-Gi-Oh Legacy and I must say it's not that good. They could have done the same game for GBA. I don't know. I mean... It's honestly... I feel with a game like Yu-Gi-Oh, I think the point is that you can use, you know, every of the available spells or something like that. I don't think... Well, I don't know. Maybe it's like Pokemon, that even if you play an old game that clearly doesn't have every Pokemon, it's like... It's the way it is. People talk shit about children card games, but Yu-Gi-Oh has complex ass rules. It's trash. Play the old Tag Force game, 20 times more fun. Huh. Wonder how many games Yu-Gi-Oh has. Probably a lot. Well, considering how popular it was, I don't doubt it. Damn, the nurse got killed. Damn, you're really gonna hide there? You can't hide forever. Spell shield. What was backfire? Oh, consume the card in another slot. I don't know, and I don't think I prefer that. Yeah, I could use minefield. I don't think it's that bad of a spell. Seems that you like Tag Force. I don't know what it is, so I wouldn't be able to give an opinion, but you know. Interesting. Tag Force. It's a cool name, at least. Or from the 5DS era, The 5DS. What 5DS? The 5DS. An interesting... interesting name. Ah, goddammit, she didn't fall for a single one of those. Damage. Boom. My damage is even more than that. And that's actually gonna be full health, because it's 100 here is the full health. 5D means the 5 dragons. The 5 dragons. An interesting name. The story got fucked and there were 6 dragons. It was just a kid, bro. They're actually, you know, they're actually more. 5 dragons. But it's a pretty good troll, I gotta say, though. You thought we were 5? Well, think again. Pretty cool. Gotcha. I remember the... that reminds me of the 6 heroes of Blaze Blue. See, that's something that they kept... you know, something that they kept constant. At the beginning there were 6 heroes and they continued being 6 heroes until the end. The gun is dealing a lot of damage. Yes, because this character specifically deals, for each shot he does, half of the damage that you have, half of the money that you have. Like, so for example, I have 1,000 at 600 points of money, so that basically means that every shot that I do will do 800 points of damage. It's really good. The problem is that he starts out really, really slow. He's really weak at the beginning. But, you know, other than that, he's pretty good in the endgame, but he's also a little bit of a glass cannon. He struggles quite a lot when it comes to not dying. So, you know, he also is really slow when he's shot, so that's a problem. It's way too early to be hungry. We'll make a burger. Like a true American. A hamburger. Ah, fuck. Alright, that's fine. Don't insult me. What a fucking bigot. There is a guy named Crow Hogan in the anime that got so popular that the whole story was rewritten to give him more screen time, and his deck was one of the best at the time, so that also helped. I see. Burgers are a good time. Yeah, I like burgers. Well, I mean, I don't think there is anyone that doesn't like burgers. Even people that are vegan like burgers, it's just that they like their vegan burgers, but I mean, they like it too. Okay, this is really bad because I'm almost half health and I'm gonna fight against the hardest boss in the game. So I'm probably gonna die, but I'm gonna make sure that I spam all of my shots, even if that means... Jesus fucking Christ. That was basically a race to see who will die first. And the problem is that the boss that comes now is gonna be like that too. Like, this boss that is gonna come right now is gonna be a monstrosity to defeat with this guy, because she moves so much. I need to do something here. Fuck. See how she's moving? Get fucking fucked. Wait. Oh, that's right. Okay, she revives. Yeah, I forgot about the cutscene. It's been so long since I defeated this boss that I was like, what? I'm getting bullshitted. But no, no, this is to be intended. Good shit, we got it. Yeah, that was a speed kill. I mean, that's what I say. This guy... Wait, what? Are we going to a den? Or... Damn, I forgot how... No, the game ends here, right? Like, we don't have to play a den. Alright, and I got the achievement of no use of, you know, not using a single artifact. Sheesh, that was everything that had to happen. I unlocked the costume of this guy, I got one of the hardest, or one of the hardest achievements of the game, and I also unlocked a new Hell Pass level. This was such a good run. It was such a good run. Unexpected. That was definitely unexpected, but good shit, dude. Oof. This guy is a beast. Shiso is a fucking beast. He just starts, you know, he rolls whatever this part of the revolver is called. Is it called barrel? Well, whatever it's called, it just... Psh, and they just die. And yeah, this picture is the same in the new... Like, if you kill Terrible, the picture is the same, except that obviously Terrible is not... Is... Wait. I think... Yeah, she... I think her seat is empty, but... The seat that was empty in the other picture... That place... That wasn't Terrible in... Whatever, who gives a shit? I have to check that again, because maybe I got confused, but... The seat that was empty in the other ending, right there, the magician girl was sitting there, not Terrible. Or maybe they are, well, they look really similar, so maybe I just got confused. Notice something about this guy, Shiso. As you can see, the runtime 31 minutes. So, most runs that I do are between 45 minutes to 50 minutes. This guy, in the end of the game, kills bosses so fast that a lot of time gets chopped out. But as you can see, look at my health, 101. So, I was pretty much 2 or 1 hit away from death. So, this guy is the definition of a glass cannon. Revolver cylinder, oh, that's how it's called, I see. So now I got a pretty cool costume, or at least it looked like a really cool costume in the shadow. Yeah, the cowboy. I like how that looks. Damn, he even gets a beard and a mustache. Pretty cool. Midnight, consume all remaining spells and cast them. Wait, that's absolutely broken. Like... If I get this spell as the first one in my deck, and I have like 50 spells, like, this is gonna crash the game. If I use that. Cast a random spell. And these are some stoner-ass spells. And look at that, I only have 4 unlocks remaining. Man, I've been playing this game so much, it's insane. Jeez.